Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the day 2 of current ARD series for NABARD Grade A exam. I hope your preparations are going well, and if you have any confusions, any doubts, or if you feel like you need guidance, please join NABARD Exam 2024 mentorship by Clarity for sure. So let's get started with today's video. When is the National Fish Farmers Day celebrated? So it is celebrated on July 10 every year. So today is National Fish Farmers Day. The National Fish Farmers Day is celebrated to honor the contributions of which individuals in the Indian fisheries sector? So it is celebrated because of the contributions of Professor Dr. Hiralal Chaudhary and Dr. K.H. Alikunni. So National Fish Farmers Day is celebrated on 10th of July every year to recognize and appreciate the invaluable contributions of everyone who is related to the fisheries sector. So National Fish Farmers Day is celebrated to recognize the contributions of Professor Dr. Hiralal Chaudhary and his colleague Dr. K.H. Alikunni, because they have guided induced breeding and reproduction in Indian major carps by hypophysation technique. This is nothing but artificially breeding the fishes by inducing a hormone called gonadotropin, so that the eggs and sperms are released in a specific time interval, which is going to help in breeding. So this technique was revolutionary in the aquaculture industry. So that is why 10th July is celebrated as National Fish Farmers Day. Which of the following statements about the MSP is incorrect? MSP is announced before the sowing season. MSP is intended to provide floor price to farmers. MSP helps in stabilizing prices during bumper production. This is also true because when there is bumper production, then the prices of that commodity will decrease because supply in the market has increased, and this will result in the farmers not even meeting their cost of production. So MSP helps in stabilizing those prices when there is bumper production. And MSP is reviewed and revised annually. Correct. MSP is applicable only for food grains. This is wrong because, as you all know, MSP is applicable for food grains, pulses, oil seeds, and commercial crops as well. Which committee recommended the C2 plus 50% formula for MSP calculation? The Shanta Kumar Committee. It is associated with restructuring FCI. Ashok Dalwai Committee is associated with the doubling of farmers' income. Mohan Singh Mehta Committee is associated with Krishi Vigyan Kendras. And Suresh Prabhu Committee is associated with the cooperative sector. So MS Swaminathan Committee has recommended the C2 plus 50% formula for MSP calculation. Now what is C2 plus 50? Currently we are using A2 plus FL formula for MSP calculation, for cost of production calculation. Now what is A2? A2 is cost incurred by the farmer in production of a particular crop, like the expenditure on seeds, fertilizers, pesticides, on fuel, machinery, etc. Now what is FL? FL is the value of family labor. When a family member is working on others' field or doing any other work, he will earn some income. But when he is working on his own field, he is not earning that income. So that value is also included. So that is A2 plus FL. And currently MSP calculation follows A2 plus FL formula. But the Swaminathan Committee has recommended C2. Now what is C2? C2 is A2 plus FL plus interest on value of owned capital assets. The interest on the value of capital assets that are owned by the farmer, and rent paid for leased in land. If the farmer has leased in the land for production, then the rent paid for that land should also be included. Or if the farmer owns the land, then the rental value of that owned land should also be included. So that is C2. So C2 plus 50 is obviously more than A2 plus FL. So MS Swaminathan Committee has recommended this formula for calculation of MSP. Which institution in India is primarily responsible for recommending the MSPs for various agriculture crops? This is a popular question, and the answer to this question is Commission for Agriculture Costs and Prices. CACP works under Agriculture Ministry. So CACP recommends the MSP for various agriculture crops. Which of the following factors is or are considered by CACP while recommending MSP? So as we have seen, the cost of production is involved in the calculation of MSP. And along with cost of production, CACP also takes into consideration the demand and supply conditions, inter-crop price parity, domestic and international prices. So all of the above is the answer. What is the MSP for Tur or Arhar per quintal for Kharif marketing season 2024-25? So the MSP for the Kharif marketing season 2024-25 has been announced, and the answer to this question is 7,550. These kind of questions are asked in NABARD exam, especially in phase 1. So you have to remember the values of the MSP. You can roughly remember them. So 2,300 for paddy, 2,200 for maize, 2,600 for bajra, 3,300-400 for jowar. For ragi, it's 4,200. And I think the question can come from pulses, because the center has been focusing mainly on pulses these days. So please remember the values of pulses. For oil seeds, for sesamum, it is 9,267, and also for cotton. Next question. Which portal has been launched for the registration of farmers to avail the facility of assured pulses procurement at MSP? So it is eSamriddhi portal. Which organizations are responsible for implementing the eSamriddhi portal? So NAFED and National Cooperative Consumers Federation of India Limited. These two organizations are responsible for implementing the eSamriddhi portal. So farmers can get registered in this portal, and their production or their pulses will be procured by the government at MSP. By which year does India aim to achieve self-sufficiency in pulse production? So India has been aiming to achieve self-sufficiency in pulse production by 2027. Which scheme is being rolled out from the current Kharif season to increase pulse production? So to change the country, first we have to change the village. So it is Model Pulses Village Scheme. So in the Model Pulses Village Scheme, after the harvest of the rice, the land will not be left fallow, but the land will be utilized for pulses production. So the Union Minister for Agriculture and Farmers Welfare and Rural Development, Shri Shivraj Singh Chauhan, assures 100% procurement for the farmers producing Tur, Urad and Masoor. And this will be done through eSamriddhi portal. And eSamriddhi portal has been launched through National Agriculture Cooperative Marketing Federation of India, NAFED, and NCCF for registration of farmers, and government is committed to procure these pulses at MSP for farmers registered on this portal. So India is trying to achieve the self-sufficiency in pulses by 2027, and some new initiatives have been launched, like the new Model Pulses Village Scheme. In this, the fallow lands after rice harvest will be utilized for pulse cultivation. And the government also plans to promote Tur intercropping and also established 150 pulse seed hubs. So we all know that quality seeds are very, very important if we are aiming to be self-sufficient in production of any crop for that matter. So this is it for today, guys. I hope this video was helpful, and keep reading, keep revising, keep watching these videos. Thank you so much.